zooming, panning, even wild rotating callouts. These are all made possible by animations. They grab your viewer's attention, and they're great for illustrating concepts. To really understand how animations work, we have to start with visual properties. An object's visual properties are made up of position, rotation, scale or size, and opacity, which is basically how see-through your object is. In Camtasia Studio, all of these can be adjusted with pixel-perfect accuracy in the Visual Properties tab. For example, here's the scale slider, and here's where you can add rotation. Most people take a more hands-on approach by arranging media right on the canvas. But any adjustments made there are always reflected in the visual properties, so feel free to work back and forth between the two to get things positioned just right. Now let's shift down to the timeline. This is the same text I was playing around with on the canvas. It has a set of visual properties that are constant, and therefore the text remains in the same spot from the beginning of its appearance on the timeline to the end. Here's how we can change that. There's a button in the Visual Properties tab that lets you add an animation, which appears as an arrow right on top of the media. This animation is a change from one set of visual properties to another, a bridge from a beginning to an end. And the length of the animation arrow determines how long the change will take, or the speed of the animation. When you first add an animation, it won't appear to have changed anything, and that's because technically it's transitioning between two identical sets of visual properties. So it's really after adding an animation that the work is done. To adjust what an animation does, first select the media. Then, putting the playhead on the right side of the animation will allow you to change the visual properties of the end state. Likewise, putting the playhead anywhere on the left side lets you change the animation's starting point. Also, double-clicking on the arrow will automatically move the playhead to the end state of that particular animation. Now let's go fiddle with that text a bit. Now we can preview what we just did, an animation from beginning to end. This one's pretty basic. In fact, something simple often works out for the best, but the freedom is there to achieve complicated effects with a little experimentation. Let's keep going and explore a couple more animation options. By right-clicking on an animation, you can choose to copy it. Right-click again, and you can then paste that animation. This would be useful, say, if you wanted a set of different images to all animate in the same fashion. Right-click again. Here's the option for setting the easing. Your choices are to have no easing, or to ease the animation's in and out points. Eased animations move at a variable speed, moving slower out of the gate and easing into the finish. Animations without easing move at a constant speed, but both methods will take exactly the same amount of time to get from point A to point B. In general, I prefer the look of an eased animation. It just seems more natural, but most of the time it's nothing more than a stylistic choice. Each added animation is given the default easing setting. To set this, go to Tools, Options, and establish your preference here. That about wraps up our in-depth look at animations. With a little practice, you'll be directing attention and sending things flying across your screen in no time. Here's a survey link to let us know what you thought of this tutorial, and as always, thanks for watching.